to CTV Special Events Coverage. I'm your host, John Losing. Today, we're at the 7th Annual Calabasas Relay for Life here at A.E. Wright Middle School in Calabasas. Relay for Life is a signature fundraising event for the American Cancer Society. Each year, at thousands of communities across the country, participants and volunteers form teams, and those team members walk around the track, walk on site for 24 consecutive hours. 24 straight hours, because cancer never sleeps. So we'll be going from morning until night. And right now, let's get started with some of the opening comments at the front stage.
It is so great to see this outpouring of love and devotion and volunteerism here in the community of Calabasas.
It's a wonderful event, and the city of Calabasas is lucky to have such a great team to put on an event like this.
During the next 24 hours, we will be walking the track, making new friends, and coming together to celebrate life.
I'm Romy Winnett, and I'm a childhood survivor of Hodgkin's lymphoma.
It all gets started with a survivor's lap to open Relay for Life. One out of three Americans will be stricken with cancer, and these survivors are the real heroes in the struggle against this disease.
Relay for Life is a life-changing event that brings together more than 3 million people.
We decided to take a lap with Mayor John Wolfson, who was out representing the City of Calabasas team. John, the city is a main sponsor again this year, as always. What's important about this event?
You know what? The relay is a great event. It gets a lot of people out in the community involved in, you know, one of the major issues of our time is cancer and treating cancer.
Celebrate the lives of those who have battled cancer. Remember loved ones lost to the disease. Fight back, because we desperately want to put an end to the disease.
Has the disease affected you personally in any way?
Yes, we have survivors in our family. Thank God, lots of people that are affected, and I'm sure everyone here either has a family member or a friend that's had cancer and been affected by it.
What goes into putting on an event of this magnitude?
Well, we started back in September. It's a lot of work getting everything donated, all of our food, a lot of the DJ, the music, and the bands all come for free. Some of the stuff we do have to pay for, but we get a wonderful grant from the City of Calabasas.
And the city has put together a team. It'll be spending the night walking the track for 24 straight hours and raising some money too, right?
Yes, raising a lot of money. Actually, right now the city team, which is led by Robert Yalda and Maureen Tomori, is the top fundraiser at the event this year so far.
How many teams are here? How many volunteers walking the track? What kind of numbers are we talking about?
We have close to 40 teams this year, and we have somewhere around 450 participants.
Stronger and better by fighting this insidious disease.
What does Relay for Life mean? What's it mean to the community? What's it mean to the survivors?
It means a lot to survivors, because this event is really celebrating them and their struggle.
Sandra, tell us a little bit about your story and why you're out today.
All right, well, I'm very fortunate. I'm a cancer survivor at this point. Last year I was diagnosed with breast cancer. in two places, and I had two surgeries in the hopes that I wouldn't have to have a complete mastectomy, and I was very fortunate that the second surgery was completely successful to date. I'm being monitored, you know, every 6 months and seeing my oncologist, and so far I'm cancer-free and I feel very, very lucky and very blessed.
Was there cancer in your family?
Yes, there was. My mother, my grandmother, my aunts, it's through our family, yes.
Well, we've caught up with Ari Tamir and his family. They're from Thousand Oaks, and this Calabasas event really does draw participants from all around the community. Ari, your daughter has had a struggle with cancer.
Yes.
Can you tell us her story?
Yeah, when she was 7 months old, I took her to a checkup at her pediatrician, and he noticed she had like a very high white blood count. So we took her to Children's Hospital, and we found out she was diagnosed with JMML leukemia, which they say pretty much with chemotherapy and a transplant is like only about 20% survival rate. And she received her transplant about 2 years ago.
And how's she doing?
She's doing good. She's 100% donor and she's doing good. And yeah, in April, it was her 2 year anniversary for her transplant. So
well, that's a wonderful story, and she deserves that Purple Survivor Medal that she has. Folks, thanks for coming out and thanks for participating.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sharon. What does the event mean to you today, coming out here?
Well, this is my first time. My son is also here as part of a team, and so I'm here, you know, supporting him and supporting the event. And I think it's for a wonderful cause. And you know, you hear so much about, you know, every day people getting diagnosed, and every minute, and you know, more and more of your friends and family being diagnosed. And so it's for a very, very important cause.
Thanks in part to the work of the American Cancer Society, for the first time in history, the number of all cancer deaths and new cases has begun to decline. Money raised from the Calabasas Relay for Life will be used for cancer research, advocacy, and patient services. What should women do to be proactive in protecting themselves?
Well, absolutely have a mammogram every year. I mean, with the grace of God and a good eye of a radiologist, he spotted my cancer, and I think it's very important that women should absolutely do that every single year.
Sandra, thank you, and thanks for coming out, and you're going to be here all day and all evening, are you?
I'll be here all day for sure. I'm not sure about this evening. I have a young one at home, so.
You go get him. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
For the land of the free, hear the
Cancer Society and Relay for Life extend an invitation to you to celebrate, remember, and fight back, to celebrate those who have struggled against cancer, to remember loved ones lost, and to fight back against this heinous disease. The city of Calabasas has been proud to be part once again of Relay for Life. It's the seventh consecutive year, and we hope you've enjoyed the program. I'm John Losing. For everybody here at CTV, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.